Dear students, good morning to all. Today in this class, we are going to learn the second lesson of the textbook Flamingo. And the name of this lesson is The Lost Spring. So, the question raises, how the spring can be lost? So students, you know very well, spring is the name of a season. And what changes do we find in spring season? There is nothing but greenery everywhere in the world. The trees bear new leaves and the flowers blossom in this season. So it's a symbol of happiness. And the lost spring means happiness lost. Whose happiness? Here we can say, as we find in the story, there are two main characters, Mukesh and Saheb. Mukesh and Saheb, they have to earn money to support their family. And they don't know what is childhood. In other words, we can say that they have lost their childhood. And childhood is the symbol of a spring season. So the lost spring is the most appropriate heading of this story. And the story, whole story is divided into two parts. The first part talks about the writer's impression about the life of the unfortunate rag pickers. The rag pickers have migrated from Dhaka and settled at Simapuri in Delhi. Simapuri is a slum area in Delhi. They have come here to find their living. The author watches a rag picker, his name is Saheb, every morning. He scrounges for gold in her neighborhood. Garbage is the means of survival for elders, and for the children, it is something wrapped in wonder. They find a coin or two from it. These people too have desire and ambition, but they don't know how to achieve them. Later, Saheb joins a tea stall where he could earn rupees 800 and all the meals per month. The job has taken away his freedom. And the second part deals with the life of Mukesh. Mukesh belongs to the family of bangle makers. He lives in Firozabad, and Firozabad is best known for its glass blowing industry. Nearly 20,000 children are engaged in this business. Life is dingy cells and working close to hot furnaces make these children blind when they step into the adulthood. They don't have any support. Even the politicians, policemen, middlemen, and bureaucrats, they all don't let them make progress. So, most women of this family think that this is their fate and they have to live the same life. But Mukesh is different from his fox. He has dreams of becoming a motor mechanic. The garage is quite far from his house, but he decides to walk. So, dear students, this is all about the summary of this lesson. And now, I would like to ask some questions to you. They are very simple questions. I hope you can answer. Who is Sahib-e-Alam? Second question is, who is Mukesh? Third question is, what does Mukesh want to be in his life? Fourth question is, how much Sahib earned in a tea stall? And the last question, how do you justify the heading, The Lost Spring, of this story? Thank you. Dear students,